the dear students, so today we are going to study domestic refrigerator. So how refrigerator works, what is its function, we are going to study regarding that. So this is one of the model of domestic refrigerator, in which you can see this is the main door. After opening this main door, we can see these different compartments. So on the door side, we are having different storage compartment for storage of various food products. And in this side, this is the main evaporator unit of the refrigerator, in which the cooling effect is produced by refrigeration cycle. Vapor compression refrigeration cycle is used to produce the refrigeration effect. Below this evaporator, we are having this chiller plate, in which if anything is required to be chilled and not freezed, can be stored. And below this evaporator section, we are having cold storage section, in which different food products which are required to be stored in the cold conditions can be then stored. So the heat transfer mechanism of heat transfer for this particular system is working on the basis of density difference of air, in which warm air is lighter and it moves upward, and when it touches the evaporator coils, it gets cooled, and then as it cools, its density increases and then it falls back again. So this is how natural convection currents are formed inside the domestic refrigerator, and whole cabinet is cooled. So this main evaporator section, it is surrounded by the evaporator tubes. Here we can see these are evaporator tubes on which this frosting can be seen. So these evaporator tubes are having a larger surface area by use of wrapping around this metallic container. So this metallic container acts as a heat exchange surface. Now coming on to the main working of the refrigeration cycle itself, so we will have to go at the back side. So here at the back side, we can see that this is the compressor. So this main compressor unit here, we can see this is hermetically sealed kind of compressor, so which works on the reciprocating motion. The refrigerant comes here from the evaporator only, and then it this compressor compresses it, and after compressing, the refrigerant becomes hot and pressure increases. So to remove that excess heat, the compressed refrigerant is sent to the condenser tube. So here we can see this is the condenser. So this section, these tubings are the condenser tubes. So from the compressor, it comes via these pipelines. So here these pipelines are also forming part of condenser. So it goes via these pipelines. So these pipelines are serving as a heat exchange area, and to further increase the heat exchange area, these metallic wires are welded onto these pipelines, so that extended surface or heat transfer can then be provided. So room air will be used to transfer the heat from hot refrigerant, so that it loses some of the heat energy and then it condenses. So the refrigerant then becomes at higher temperature in liquid state. So from compressor, it was coming in high temperature, high pressure vapor state, and in the condenser, it then becomes high pressure, near to atmospheric temperature, liquid state. So the work of condenser is to condense the high pressure, high temperature vapor refrigerant to high temperature, high pressure and ambient temperature liquid. So that liquid, high pressure liquid refrigerant then can be sent back to the next component of the refrigerant cycle. So here we can see after this condenser tube, when this ends, so it ends at this particular junction here, and after this junction there is a small tube. So this small tube is capillary tube, which is the fourth component of the refrigeration system. So basically it works as a throttling valve. So in which what happens, that high pressure liquid refrigerant leaves from a larger cross sectional area towards the smaller cross sectional area, so that its velocity increases. When the velocity increases, its pressure decreases. So as the pressure decreases, it cools down.
Because of Bernoulli's theorem, you might have studied in your fluid mechanics classes. In the Bernoulli's theorem, what happens? That total energy remains constant, and when the kinetic energy is converted, this potential pressure energy is converted into kinetic energy, its pressure energy also reduces. And due to reduction in pressure, as a side effect of reduction in pressure, temperature also reduces. So here we can see that this capillary tube is going to via this particular conduit inside the refrigerator unit to the evaporator coils, where it is meeting the evaporation temperature of refrigerant to the inside component of the refrigerator, where the heat transfer takes place, and this lower pressure liquid refrigerant will be evaporating into lower temperature, lower pressure vapors, and then the cycle repeats.